We're still very bullish about the U.S. and conventional potential. By far, in the last 10 years, it is the true disruption in our energy landscape. So we have made a substantial investment, taking advantage of the opportunities offered by the shale revolution in the U.S. So we made a big substantial investment in the petrochemical space. Lately, also, we made an investment in an LNG developer next decade, driven by our understanding that the shale revolution in the U.S. will continue. However, there are headwinds, including what some of the Democratic nominees are...
The front-runner of the Democratic race at the moment.
...are promoting, and I think the consequences of these decisions need to be carefully evaluated and fully understood, but it might be a very challenging decision to switch off the activity.
It's very interesting that Middle Eastern companies are looking at Western partners and now looking at the political risk there rather than Western companies looking at Middle East and worrying about the political risk here. So let me ask you a very simple question. Is it easier to do business with Eastern partners, emerging market partners, who don't have the same political risks as you could potentially see when dealing with the United States and dealing with other Western countries?
Yeah. Welcome to the new world.
It is interesting that that's a completely changing dichotomy, isn't it?
It is, in fact, an interesting phenomena. I think as in a financial institution, we look at these parameters carefully. We study the risk associated with any investment, and we take our decision accordingly. Yes, there are emerging trends, especially in the West, when it comes to the climate change agenda, sustainability, the ESG, and that's something that we need to carefully monitor. However, in the East, we know that the market and the growth is more attractive, and we keep our eyes open for both, sides, and we're taking our investment decisions based on a carefully studied parameters.
So it's geostrategic, it's economic.
Yes.
Walk me through your take on the Aramco IPO prospectus.
There is no doubt that Aramco is the most profitable company globally. I think it is the company, if you are interested in the energy space, this is the company, the crown jewel of the energy. However, we are an institution, a financial institution. We are going to look at the potential financial returns, and we're going to take our views based on these financial returns.
From an investor point of view, from a partner point of view, does the world need another listed energy company? Because I've been looking at some amazing research recently, and you both have seen the same kind of research as I have, that are actually saying that investors are demanding a much bigger premium. They're demanding higher dividend yields in order to invest in listed IOCs and now potentially a listed NOC as well. Yeah. So I ask you from an investor's point of view, does the world need Aramco? In terms
the Saudis
of
certainly need it.
Yes, so,
or do
yeah,
they?
That's the seller. I'm asking about the buyers.
As long as the world will require energy for the foreseeable future, my answer is yes. There will be a need for.
But Saudi Aramco will be there regardless, so whether it's listed or not.
But Saudi Aramco is differentiated by many parameters, including potentially the lowest cost producer globally. So if you believe in this sector, if you believe in the long term view of this sector, these are the type of companies you need to look at.
Hey everybody, it's Hadley Gamble from our new CNBC Middle East Bureau in Abu Dhabi. Thanks for stopping by. Now to watch more, you can try one of the videos that just popped up on your screen. And don't forget to subscribe.